Hi, I'm Kili, also known as Kelly.
And I'm Feely, also known as Alex.
Welcome to our corner of the Shire,
where we will show you how to bring Middle Earth
into your daily life to keep you
a happy hobbit.
Welcome to this episode of Happy Hobbit. As you're going about your spring cleaning, you're probably going to start to uncover a lot of mathoms that you didn't know you had. For those of you who aren't hobbits, mathoms are trinkets. They're special little objects that we hobbits like to collect. Like, you know, potentially this ball twine could be a mathom. Or it could be like your first baby tooth, or a scale from Smaug, or piece of dwarf beard, or you know, maybe a ball of roots that looked really cool, like two carrots who grew together, or that one earring that you keep around because you're always hoping to find the other pair, or the other part of the pair. Don't worry! Today, we're gonna explore some ways that you can make a mathom holder, a mathom keeper, a little something that's gonna be like a mathom itself to help with your spring cleaning. So, like a lot of things on Happy Hobbit, I've never actually done this before, and I don't really have a plan. This is just something I kind of imagined, and we're gonna see how it works. So, what we're gonna start with is a root guard. Now, this is something that you can get from your local hardware store or garden store, and I've chosen it because the peacock agrees. I've chosen it because, look, the edges are already smoothed. You don't have to worry about getting stabbed as you work this edge as well. And these edges are sealed off. Now when you're picking one of these, they come in two packs. And this is the 1 gallon size, and it's about $6 for a pair. But you want to be a little bit picky because you're not going to actually use it as a root guard. This edge here on some of the ones that have been, for lack of a better expression, more sloppily made, will be hanging off. And you want to try to pick ones that you know, are symmetrical and don't have a lot of material hanging on. So, you will need a root guard, some dead branches, or in this case, tragically, one of our young birch trees died this winter, and now he's gonna contribute to this mathom keeper. You will also need a saw, and some twine, and possibly some wire. We'll see if that comes into use later. And of course, wire cutters and scissors. This is a lot of sharp objects, so children, if you're gonna try this, do it with adult supervision. So to start things off, we're gonna take our patient here, put him on the operating table. So you can see, he's got a lot of limbs that need to be cut off. And what I'm planning on doing is taking some of the skinnier ones and cutting them to be just longer than the edges of our root guard. Because what we're gonna do is take these dead branches and essentially create a frame, like a picture frame.
Right? Are you sure that's not the White Tree of Gondor? Because I saw you leaving Gondor with something in a bag.
In a bag?
It was big.
That would be like twice as big as I am. Wait, I
do you have a white beard?
Not Santa Claus. This is gonna be a unique experience, folks. Sign on a table. Yep. Can I use the other saw? I'm gonna get the real saw.
It's like it's doing a lot of damage, Kaylee!
So, folks, when you're usually sawing something like this, it's good to do it on a deck or somewhere where you can stand on the end. Not have to deal with such wobbly things. Alright, so, we've got a piece of the birch tree. And, this length here looks like, he'll do nicely for our mathom keeper. So I have my first piece of straight birch wood, well, relatively straight. It's fine if it looks crooked, if it looks funky, that's just gonna make it look all the more rustic when you finish it off. So what I'm gonna do is just kinda eyeball it. And I think it would be good to have it about that length. And leave a little extra on the edge. And yeah, we'll go from there. So I now have a piece for the top and a piece for the side. And I'm gonna get another piece for the bottom. And I want it to be around the same thickness as the one on the top, just for consistency. So I'm gonna take from the middle of this branch here and then be close to seeing what we do next.
Cutting dwarf style.
If you have a little trouble with the saw, don't worry about it. We can't all be lumberjacks. In fact, we all shouldn't be. The Ents really would not appreciate that.
I don't know if the Ents would appreciate this.
It's dead already. Like, this is basically like someone taking your fingernails and doing artwork with them, as far as an Ent's concerned.
I mean, that's what I do.
It's kind of gross. I was actually just using that, like, metaphorically.
Well...
Right, so I've got the two bomb pieces. This is probably too thick for the side, but... get some use out of this. This is gonna be the other side. It's kind of skinny, but... so I'm gonna cut it a little extra long for right now. So what I'm doing now is just kind of eyeballing where I want to arrange them, and I've decided that I want to put the skinnier ones down first as the first layer. Now, for those of you who ever played with Lincoln logs, you know what I'm talking about. You kind of have to strategize how you lay your pieces of wood. So I'm putting the thin ones on the bottoms, because if I put the thick ones on the bottom, these would be floating up high. And since they're thin, they don't cover that much anyway, and it might look kind of silly. So I'm gonna put, actually maybe I could put them the long way. Put them like this, and then I'll have these pieces like that. And it's starting to take shape. So what I'm doing is just literally taking the twine and I'm gonna weave it through, like as if I were sewing. And that will hold my mathom in place. And then hold my piece of wood in place. So I've chosen twine, but you could do it with whatever you wish. Just remember that the fun of this project is to make it, it is the flaws, really. You don't want it to look perfect, or it'll just be weird. Because that's not appropriate for a mathom. Mathoms are unique items, and this is a unique craft project. So once you get to the corner, it should be pretty easy to just sort of tie the next section of the frame in place by using your extra string and going in through the holes in the metal a couple times. It literally looks like something that might be in Winnie the Pooh's house.
Winnie the Pooh has got style.
Yeah, like this is something that... I don't know why I always find a way to bring up Winnie the Pooh when I really should be referencing Bayorn. I'm gonna do the same thing with the extra on this side, and I'm just kind of eyeballing the wood and choosing which side I'd like to face out. And so I think this side is pretty. I kind of don't really want to have to look at all the spots where I cut off parts of the branch, because I think that that's not as pretty as just the natural wood, especially when you have birch, because it has such pretty bark. So I've put the last piece on, and I've made sure to put it on underneath these other two pieces so that they're relatively even. And now I'm just going to keep on weaving all the way down. So as you're weaving, just make sure to keep pulling the twine tight, and this end might slip and come off of the bottom piece of wood, and so you just want to keep an eye on it and keep it in place. Otherwise you are going to find it difficult to move, because you'll have pulled this so tight. So I just have a big chunk of twine that I'm essentially sewing with. For those of you who don't know how to sew, this is basically sewing. This particular brand of twine is Sasquatch hair. I like it because it's not only water resistant, but it's supporting the local Sasquatch community, who doesn't really have a voice, at least in this part of California. The Sasquatch community doesn't have, you know, they're not even allowed to vote. So, you know, shaving and weaving their hair is one of the things they can do to support themselves. But so,
what if you want to try to support dwarves? Because I know for a fact there are a few from the Blue Mountains who do sell their beard hair as twine.
Well, I know for a fact that they are not hurting for money. So, they have a king under the mountain. They have piles of gold. Support Sasquatches, not dwarves. That's all it comes down to. I mean, you could support dwarves in other endeavors. I'm not saying to not support them in any walk of life, but
I just don't know how Thorin or anyone would be okay with this, because I don't think they get along very well, Sasquatch and, you know.
I mean, that's sort of their thing, though. Like, that, they can work that out. I'm not really gonna get involved. Okay, so here we go. Very end. May have enough twine here. So, of course, my twine ran out just almost at the end, so I added some more. And I am putting on the finishing touches. So I'm just forcing this through to tie as a knot here. And there we go. This is pretty sturdy. It's looking pretty good. So personally, I don't like these extra ends, so I'm gonna find a way to hide them. Probably by just tying them off in the back. So there you have it. This is a Mathom holder that I have just purely made by winding twine around. I was able to get it relatively tight, and if you finished yours and it wasn't as tight as you wanted and it doesn't quite feel so secure, you can either go over it again with some more twine, especially in the corners there, or you can use a little bit of wire, which I anticipated I might need, but it turns out mine's pretty good. So all that's left really is to take a little bit more twine or a piece of wire, that's what you want. And I'm just tying off the ends so that it doesn't fray. And it's time to make a little loop for the back. See, this is about the center. And I guess I'll just tie this off. In fact, I'm going to tie it on the back so I don't have to look at it. Because I do get a little bit particular about these things. So with a loop like this, you'll be able to hang it from a hook or a nail or anything you want. Right, there you have it. So I have a little loop that I can hang this from. Now, there's a lot of ideas that you can do just using this basic concept. I had this idea by looking at something that was in a magazine, and they had taken an old mirror frame or an old picture frame that was kind of ornate, and they just had put chicken wire in the back to make like a little knick-knack holder. And I thought, well, you could either go to the Goodwill and get an old frame, or you could make your own frame. You could, if you wanted, you could spice this up by painting the wire white to make it a little bit more uniform. You could put fabric on the back, like a flower pattern or any sort of pattern that you like, to make it just look a little bit more kind of country-ish, I guess. Just whatever you like, really. You could make one of these a little bit more rustic to put in your garage. And let's go see what Mathoms we can find to put on our Mathom holder. So here I've hung our Mathom holder up, and I'm just putting on the finishing touches of little knickknacks I didn't really have a spot for. If you have little clothespins like this, some miniature clothespins, those work great. See, you can even use it to hang your earrings on. So you could use this for a jewelry holder. Or even like an art project in and of itself, if you're feeling that crafty. So there you have it. All kinds of things you can do. They're
is no limit to the imagination, boys and girls. None. Let your wildest dreams come true. Speaking as someone who sailed on the Hawaiian chieftain. That was a dream of mine. It came true. Follow your dreams. Follow them!
Mathom.
So when you leave the ends hanging out like this, it makes it a nice little spot for you to hang necklaces and headbands or any little knick-knacks like that that are light so that they don't put the whole Mathom holder off kilter. And there you have it. So folks at home who are going to try their hand at this, I expect to see photos on our Facebook page. I'd love to see what twists or unique spins that you guys put on it. And the possibilities really are endless. So I hope that this is going to help you with your spring cleaning. And I hope that learning how to make a Mathom holder has left you a very happy hobbit.
Okay, hold on.
Sun is a movie we're playing this. Don't you watch Cosmos?
I always get that one mixed up. She did it pretty good, ma'am. Should we get her a coffee now, or? Hey!
Okay, I'm serious. My face hurts from smiling.
I know.
Where is my PA?
Jorge never came back.
Well,
after last time. Oh, Jorge, run!
Welcome to this segment of Behind the Happy Hobbit, Behind the Scenes. Come back.
Oh, okay. Are you sure?
I'd like to show you two of my personal assistants. As you can see, they stay out of view of the camera,
oh.
But they're here to cater to my every whim. This is Tayla. She is my makeup artist, and she's.
She looks pretty hungry there.
She's.
Does she get lunch breaks?
This is her lunch break. This is Comanche. And he's like, you know, he's kind of my spiritual advisor.
Oh.
Like,
do you sometimes have breakdowns on set, or?
Not sometimes, almost every time.
Okay.
So, like, happy hobbit.
Not always so happy.
I know it. It's the guilt. It's the guilt from stealing the tree. I know. That's what I said, too.
Can you, like, cheer me up? Like, I'm just gonna, like, hang out here for a
minute. Kili, there's this weird man who keeps talking behind me.
Who is it?
He talks like this.
See, this is why he's my, like, this is why he's my spiritual advisor. He just got an avalanche on him.
He took part of the...
And he didn't react. I'm sorry, Chi-Chi. I'm sorry.
Oh, he...
That's a wire. You shouldn't lie on that. See, he's calm. He's bomb-proof. That's why he's such a good guide.
Yes, I can see that.
And his birthday is September 22nd. You can't go wrong with
Hashtag
that.
Awesome. This man takes the brunt!
What happened?
See, she's also a medic. She's coming to check things out.
She's a lot of degrees.
Yeah, she is a career woman. She's an educated woman.
Aren't you, Tayla?
Okay, sorry, that one fell on my personal assistant. Oh, poor little girl.
Advice at home, do not do this while you're...
Yes, if you're doing this at home, maybe, like, tell your dogs that it's great that you have their support, but it's kind of dangerous.
We have some stalkers on set. Turkeys. At 1 o'clock.
Oh, my spiritual advisor is moving on.
Oh, maybe he's sick of getting rained on by the ingredients.
This Sasquatch twine is pretty strong.
I heard Saruman's beard was going for pretty high a price.
Oh yeah, that stuff?
Like
that stuff's like heat tempered. That's like mm-hmm. basically like stronger than any metal.
Mm-hmm. That's pretty rare, so don't get your hopes up for eBay.
Yeah, I mean, like, I've seen some on eBay for, like, starting at...
It was, like, 10 grand an inch.
I saw centimeter. Like, you saw, that's a steal, 10 grand an inch?
It was gone the next morning.
Someone knew what they were buying.
Yeah. Can't you understand what that means?
Follow them!
Ma'am.
Not like sulking and like this, but what? Actually, like, that's a weird phrase. Don't follow your dreams. Like, just create your dreams.
After that speech, ma'am!
I'm not running for president.
Are we done yet?
Kili, that guy's back.
Who is he? Like, I can't see him.
I don't know.
No, like, he's not behind something. I physically can't see him.
I can't either. I mean, I've just been filming. He might...
He's a ghost, then. Like, the ghost of the cameraman?
Clay's new story!
Well, that's upsetting. Maybe he's a barrel riot or something.
Maybe he's related to the, tobacco incident.
Oh, that's right.
Roy Tolkien tobacco
incident. Roy Tolkien's crushed
I forgot
of tobacco cigarette Jorge, but I was actually thinking of Daryl.
Oh!
Peter Jigson's cameraman.
Peter Jigson. He is one of a kind. Maybe that's him.
Get that!
Destroyer on the set!
Get that! Oh, it's a heaven! So much branches the rolling!
Oh my goodness.
She's crazy!